Hello and welcome back to My 360 English. You're not going to find a video more exciting than this one anywhere on the internet because today we're talking about irregular verbs. Let's do it. Let's talk about a few things before we get straight into irregular verbs. All main verb types have past tense forms, and these let us talk about things which happened in the past. And these past tense forms are the past simple, which would take a verb like work and change it into worked, and the past participle, which has lots of different uses, but one of the most obvious is its use with the perfect tense, which would be I have worked in this example. Regular verbs have past tense forms which end in ed, and you'll notice that the past simple and the past participle are exactly the same. So we have I worked and I have worked, or I've worked. I stayed or I've stayed, or I cried and I've cried. A lot of commonly used verbs don't have ed on the end of their past tense forms, and we call these irregular verbs. We can't treat them like regular verbs. They don't follow any particular patterns. We have to treat them and learn them individually, one by one. Now, irregular verbs might have both their past simple and past participle the same, like brought. I brought a pen here today, and I've brought a pen here today. Or they might be different, like with to eat. I ate and I've eaten. Or they might not change from the infinitive at all, like to put. I put a chicken in the oven every Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock. That's the present simple because it's something I do regularly. I put a chicken in the oven 2 hours ago is the past simple, and I've put a chicken in the oven. It's all the same, put. And this is exactly why we call them irregular verbs, because they don't follow the rules. So I've made a list of 40 irregular verbs that I think you should know, the important ones, to get you started. First of all, we'll have the verb, like eat. Then we'll have the past simple, ate, and then the past participle, eaten. And then I've given you two examples. For example, I ate all the birthday cake and I've eaten too much. I have eaten too much. So try to focus on these examples rather than just learning from the list. Try and absorb their meaning and just get to grips with how they sound until it just seems unnatural to say I eated an apple, because that's not correct. It's I ate an apple. All right, let's get going. Let's start with the verb to be. This is the only irregular verb, which is super irregular, and has two different versions of the past simple. If we want to use I, he, she, or it, we use was. Or if we want to use you, we, and they, we use were. So we have I was excited, he was excited, she was excited, and it was excited. Or you were excited, we were excited, or they were excited. And the past participle is been. He's been good. Have. Had. Had. I had to go home. I've had enough. Eat, ate, eaten. He ate an entire birthday cake. I've eaten more than I should have. Drink, drank, drunk. I drank the potion. He's drunk it all. Get, got, got. She got angry with me. He's got the money. Give, gave, given. You gave me £10. I've given it to him. Okay, with the verb to go, the past simple is went. So I went to Paris a few years ago. However, we have two different options for the past participle. One being gone and the other being been. Gone indicates a movement away from a place, and been indicates a movement to and then away from a place. For example, she's gone away means that she's no longer there. She's gone away from a particular place. While she's been to America means that she has spent time in America, but isn't there anymore. She's been to America, but she's then moved away. She's somewhere else. Come, came, come. A horse came to my party. They've come to the conclusion that you're insane. Leave, left, and left. The dog left a mess on the carpet. I've left my keys at reception. Do, did, done. They did the job well. They've done the job well. Make, made, made. I made some cookies. I've made a mess in the kitchen. Take, took, taken. I took my time writing these examples. She's taken everything. Bring, brought, brought. He brought a book with him. I've brought my iPhone charger. Show, showed, shown. They showed me how to stand on my head. You've shown great potential here today. Put is one of those funny ones that doesn't change. So we have, I put the money on your bedside table, and I've put my shoes by the door. Keep, kept, and kept. It kept annoying me. He's kept it a secret for many years. Hold, held, and held. You held the puppy in your hands. They've held a conference on the importance of good personal hygiene. Wear, wore, worn. I wore the same jeans for 3 days. She's never worn that dress before. Tear, tore, torn. I tore off the wrapping paper. I've torn a hole in my trousers. Catch, caught, caught. I caught the ball. She's caught a cold. Run, ran, run. We ran the tap until the water was cold. He's run 8 marathons in his life. Drive, drove, driven. I drove all night. He's driven his parents up the wall with his bad behaviour. Break, broke, broken. You broke my favourite mug. Oh, I've broken my leg. Write, wrote, written. I wrote a book last year. She'd written about her experience during the war. Speak, spoke, spoken. He spoke Italian. The gods have spoken. Say, said, said. I said I didn't want to go. You've said enough. Tell, told, told. I told a lie. He's told that joke before. Think, thought, thought. I thought I saw something in the shadows. I've thought long and hard about this. Know, knew, known. You knew I couldn't keep a secret. I've known for a long time. Forget, forgot, forgotten. They forgot how to walk in a straight line. I've forgotten how to speak English. Choose, chose, chosen. I didn't choose it. It chose me. She's chosen her favourite book. See, saw, seen. I saw that film last week. I've seen that film tons of times, which means many times. Sing, sang, sung. I sang in the shower this morning. Pavarotti has sung his last song. Ring, rang, rung. She rang the doctor because she felt unwell. I've rung the bell, but there's no answer. Pay, paid, paid. You paid for that haircut. They've paid you now. Begin, began, begun. The lesson began at 1 o'clock. They've begun to get bored. Become, became, become. You became the woman I always thought you would. I've become a bit sensitive in my old age. Meet, met, met. I met a famous person in London. I've met all your friends. Lose, lost, lost. I lost my wallet on the train. You've lost. Find, found, found. I found my wallet in my pocket. They've found their inner peace through learning irregular verbs. One last thing I wanted to mention before I let you continue living your lives is you might see words like burnt and learnt and dreamt, as well as burned, learned, and dreamed. Some verbs have alternative past tense forms, and it's just that the one with the T on the end, for example, burnt, is more common in British English, and the one with ED on the end, dreamed, is more common in American English. So an American might say, I burned my finger. I burned my finger. But a British person might say, I burnt me finger, with a T on the end. So that's why, in case you're wondering. You can't do this with every verb, there are just a few that do this. If you've enjoyed this lesson, give me a like. Leave a little comment if you want to, and make sure you subscribe. And you can also head over to the Facebook page if you want to keep up to date with everything that's going on. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Cheers.